Virtually every outlet that purports to prove evolution, whether a magazine or a biology textbook or a video, uses an argument from vestigial organs to supposedly validate evolution. You see, the idea is that there are certain organs in the bodies of animals or humans that are leftovers from a time when, in a precursor organism, that organ was useful, but it no longer has a use in the modern organism. Even if there were hundreds of vestigial organs, that wouldn't prove evolution. Evolution needs organs to be getting better and adding functional design. The idea of vestigial organs really would be better suited to argue for a beginning creation in which organisms were well designed at the beginning, but after hundreds or thousands of years, genetic information was lost or corrupted, causing less functionality. If the argument from vestigial organs proves anything, which it doesn't, it would prove the idea of an original, useful design by a creator. Vestigial organs certainly don't prove evolution, but let's look at some specific examples of supposed vestigial organs and see that there really is no such thing. You see, in the late 1880s, it was suggested that there were over 185 vestigial organs, organs that were virtually useless or completely useless in the human body. What do you think happened as medical scientists and researchers started looking more closely at the human body? That list of 185 vestigial organs began to shrink gradually and then rapidly to where now there are only a handful of these organs that people will put forth as proof of evolution. The diehard evolutionists still attempt to say that some organs in the human body are vestigial. They aren't, but let's look at the ones that they suggest to us are. Number one, the appendix. For many years, people thought the appendix was a useless organ that was left over, one biologist said, from a plant-eating ancestor. Supposedly, in our precursors, it was much larger, and now we no longer need it. It has gotten smaller, and it causes problems sometimes because it can get infected and cause an appendicitis. And so we're told that that's a leftover of evolution, that it was larger and more useful in our precursor ancestors, but we don't need it now, and so it's atrophying. The problem with this is that's simply not scientific. In an article titled "Scientist, Appendix Protects Good Germs," one writer noted, "Diseases such as cholera or amoebic dysentery would clear the gut of useful bacteria. The appendix job is to reboot the digestive system in that case." Bill Parker, co-author of the latest research, said that the appendix acts like a bacteria factory, cultivating good germs. You see, people thought the appendix was useless because they didn't understand the appendix. And now we see that there is a very real, very useful aspect to the appendix that shows that it certainly is not an evolutionary vestige of some former ancestor where it was useful. It's useful now. Second vestigial organ that we'd like to put forward, it's not really even an organ. It's the idea of junk DNA. You see, for many years, as scientists looked at the human genome, they thought that there were parts of the DNA molecule that were useless. Thought that there were parts that simply were there because they were left over from evolution. They didn't program for any genetic information that played out in the human body, and they called that junk DNA. But what we've found out, as you probably understand, is that the term junk DNA is a misnomer. We called it junk DNA because we didn't know that the DNA had a very serious, very important use. In fact, the Scientific American headline stated, "What was once known as junk DNA turns out to hold hidden treasures, says computational biologist. Those hidden treasures prove that that junk DNA certainly wasn't vestigial. The third vestigial organ that we'd like to consider is that idea of the coccyx, the human tailbone. Supposedly, this coccyx, the human tailbone, is a leftover from a time when we had primate ancestors and they actually had a tail and they lost that, but the vestige of that is left in the human anatomy. And the problem with that line of thinking is it's certainly not true at all. Type in the word coccyx in Google, and from Healthline is, the coccyx serves as an attachment site for tendons, ligaments, and muscles. It also functions as an insertion point of some of the muscles of the pelvic floor. The coccyx also functions to support and stabilize a person while he or she is in a sitting position. I mean, sure, you could do without your coccyx, but you could do without your pinky, you could do without your thumb, you could do without your left eyeball, but the quality of life that you were living would definitely be reduced. You see, the vestigial argument is just that. It's a vestige of a time when scientists were ignorant of the uses and the purposes of the organs in the body. If anything needs to be cut out, it should be this useless argument that in no way validates or proves evolution.